Jamila will talk her experience first, well, her side of the story, even though we're both involved, and then I will talk my side. So without further ado, let's begin. So yes, guys, I can remember that it was a, I remember that I attended, sorry, again, watch night on December, remember, 31st or about 2017, right? Myself, my sister, and my boyfriend at the time went to church. I knew it said January 1st. Well, it would have been New Year's. And so you want to get your soul right. Because you know you normally come to church. Come in the country, you know you normally go to church. So I think we went to a church in one of our sister's friends.
We went,
yes. That's why I look up myself, your church would have come with that church. And I don't know what the message was, but me know sir, we got to church already. Enjoying the service. Service done, I will go home. But at that time, my boyfriend usually visits. Yes, sir? So me and him go with my sister. And when we are going to bed, stop it. When we are going to bed, you know, he might go like him want something. Oh, someone just come to my church, you know. I know, say, conscientiously, me like get me. I say, Jesse, man, no, me can't give none. Come just a come from church, and me just go get me soul right. So, pastor pray for me and stuff. But anyways, me give you. So it was like a cookie. It was one of them sex. It was one of those sex where I say, okay, you know, the things happen. So therefore, you have an interest. You know, the morning after something. It was one of those sex. So, you know, so the sex go on. Never enticing or so, but you know, sex go on. And then I think about like, you know, when the sex go, I'm not thinking about pregnancy.
But it's just
in the draw out, I hold up.
It was just one of them picky sex.
So yes, man, in the draw out, because once I've never draw out, I go by the man in after. But because one of them sex, they were draw out, and you know. But wow. Even after the sex go, I felt terrible. Then when you have sex, it and you just go out and say that we can be sick, and really just forgive you, you're going back and sin. All them sex there. But anyway. After all that time now, when I'm pretty nothing, I think I remember clearly I was on the bus going to work one morning and I felt so bad.
It happened immediately after?
Not immediately, girl, like yeah. Man.
But
I
try to say, like, Mr. Bo.
So this happened in December, and when were you going
this
back?
This happened what?
January?
In January, yeah, ma'am. When we got a Howard in January.
So January, so we got
the first week or second week?
No, ma'am, not the first week, like, Bo. So the sixth week on the last of December. I think both. Third week in January. I don't remember specifically, but I know that it was in January. I was going to work on a bus. One of the JETC. I mean, I felt so bad. The kind of feeling we get though was not a bad, you know, say normally I drink tea. I'm not a morning person where tea is concerned. And you make a breakfast when you wait until they reach work before you have it. So maybe that means lunch bag with my breakfast and stuff. But I felt so bad. Back to the point where I feel like no one vomit. Me and I was one of vomit. Anytime we vomit, some really do. But then, and then at this time, I was standing in the bus, never have a seat, and the bus did pack up. So I was on the rear and I messaged myself, so, no man, how I feel, so anyways, me go on, there was this man beside me, and I say, I'm lady, alright, that was how bad me feeling, like I'm all about spring water, that's how bad me feel. Anyways, me never jumped around on the retour. I think. And by the end of January, but yeah, this time I feel bad, I came home like the same day. And I don't know what I was doing in the bathroom, but I squeezed my breast. When I squeezed my breast, I see water come out of my breast. So I said, I could have already said, if my first resort was to do this, so I go, not in the room, I'm Googling. And what came on me was, like, you know, a lot of persons put things on Google when I authorize or nothing, but what came to my eyes was like, they want to say, when you see what your neighbor say, might be pregnant. It's a sign of pregnancy. Me say, wait. But that never really get me along, because me say to myself, it was not January, never done it. So, I still have it on the period, because it's going to come it.
But me, I watch the days and me, I count on the days then. Anyways, I think it's on the 30th of January. Remember that message I said? Now I'm going to see people around there. So the 28th or so, that week. But I realized that the 30th come, I'm in a sinner period. I'm saying one day left in January. So me, I said, okay, probably the period late. When the 30th come up, it was on my chest. So when I came home from work, I said to my sister, say, no, sir, I don't want to sleep here, though. I was saying to Janela, you say, I don't want to sleep here, though. And she said, yeah, man, go on with me. Let me say, I have another day. Yeah, one more day in January. So just go on with me. Anyways, I went to work on the 31st. And missed it. Every minute, then the time, then, oh. You see, then the time, every minute, my belly feel like when you have the period. You know, the period feeling. But run down the bathroom, come here, I say, yes, you feel something, come down. Well, my love, I know nothing, because you know, so my mind up in a game at this time. Anyways, 31st come now. I'm in the hour, I message myself, say, no, so I'm going to buy a pregnancy test. Guys, I have never taken a pregnancy test. I'm 32, and I have never taken a pregnancy test. This will be my first time taking one. Because you know, you're not free for a baby, you're not free for a baby yet. And you know, I've always been talking to my friends. And I said, well, you're just, yeah, man, you can't have baby if you want, because you're really reach the age of your work, you're independent. But then just a child, I'm not listening, because you know myself, I said, I'm not yet ready. Maybe it was one thing. Anyways, I went to the pharmacy in Papine and I bought a pregnancy test. And to be frank, I don't really know if I take pregnancy test. So me, I said to myself, I not take this at work. I wait until I reach home and show my sister. Because you know my sister is Janela is my sister. So yeah. Everybody pull up okay, and I said to myself, I'm not going to work because no one will show my sister, you know, so that me and I can sit down and do it. So I reach out from work, I'm going to John and I said to her, I say to her, say, you know, so I'm going to pregnancy test, and she'll say, okay, till the last of the month, so we could just watch it till 12 o'clock though. Anyways, we did that open at night, I watch, and I said, every minute my baby feel like the period will come, but no period will come. So 12 o'clock, and 12 o'clock come, she'll say, nobody take it yet, because you know sometimes the period might come in at the morning. And you know what, so I would have just one day. Tell your first come, get up, not in a panty. So, sister, come tell you this. Mark your people, I have never taken one of these tests. So I read the manual and it says, those are those tests that the stroke had to be two, you know, sir? So I'm going to the bathroom, pee-pee, on it, there was a strip on it where you pee-pee and whatever. And the result comes on the other side. And the result comes on the other side, yes. So we do the thing, do the thing, and then left the test in the bathroom. Wait a couple minutes and I go in the book. Then I went to my back and I said to me, realized it's only had one stroke. So I said, because from the manual I read that two strokes mean that you're pregnant and one means you're not pregnant. So when I said the one stroke, I said, yeah, in the clearance, over the stuff. So I said, you're not pregnant. So I said, at this time, I can never lie to you, man. But I know if a girl feels good and stuff, but I'm a good girl. Anyways, my sister said, what is this day? So I told her that the test was in the bathroom. She go in there, and she said, Jamila, if you cannot tell the test good, you saw what it means. She said, the test is showing valid. I said, let me see it. Then she showed me the test. People at this time, you know, some say invalid, then test could I, pregnancy test could be invalid. To start, come about a pharmacy, go buy one more, because you have to ensure you can do it and say you're pregnant, and then you might be pregnant. Go to the pharmacy, at this time, she said to, she go buy one, because you know, sometimes I'm jittery, I'm afraid, come here, say, you know, just imagine, you think that you're in the clear, and then she, you know, come tell you, say, it's invalid. So anyways, we got a pharmacy and this time we bought two tests because I want to buy the first test. So she said, what she's going to do, she's going to show me how to take the test. So she got in the bathroom, me and I got in the bathroom and she showed me. And she pee-pee and other thing. And then I realized that where I was supposed to put the urine around place with the pussy, it's been at the first test. And that's the result was invalid. So we told me to the pregnancy test and we put them down, come out and I wait for the result. But mama said no, at this time I'm not free my sister about nothing. I'm talking about myself here coming out of my period. I'm like, oh, my sister got your fair part. When you go to the bathroom, no. This is where my sister is going to come in. Alright, so before I give you an update as to what happened in the bathroom, let me give you a flashback as to what happened to me. So of course, you know, in the same month of December, I had my period. I'm the staff of person. Not long time in theater. I ain't no long time. I'm telling you from the previous term. I'm telling you, I said, really do from 17. So the little you think has taught me how to live as a person. And so if when me have my do my sex something and have sex, me know when it is in terms of, you know, what to buy and let me explore them with it. So I know about the man after thing. And so said me, even I'm in the smallest of a brain, she's a summer man, the man telling me, me go ahead and still take two pills and so I will prevent the pregnancy if I want to have it like that. Of course, I know, baby, I have something for mine. I'm never accomplished it yet. So my previous boyfriend, where did I always throw me out? He couldn't breathe me, he couldn't catch me. How do you think he catch me and me catching back? So because of that, now I have had this thing about me. So when my sister told me that she missed her period, I know that I would not have been in the same boat, in quotation marks, because I had seen my period in December. So me, I say, I'm clear. So when I followed her to the pharmacy and she bought the teeth and I bought a test with her, I was just taking a test, already knowing my result, just to show her how to do it. So of course, oh, girl, my not a result, but the one show. My girl, you know, that girl was talking about girl, red light come already. Yeah? Anyways, this is all they know. So when my sister and myself did the test, we left them in the bathroom, we went back into the bathroom together. This is how God worked in mysterious ways. So when we went into the bathroom, we were shocked out of our wits because both first pregnancy tests there had two drops on both of the tests. And then when we saw what was happening, my sister was saying, man, I'm the teacher on the fourth floor then. I mean, I said, no, no, sorry, you should over the test. You did one of the tests and I did one. Exactly. So at this time now, remember? I said, let me tell you, the girl thing has come and stuff. When girls are two strokes, girl, I never promised something about me. So this time I have to go to the Kiara. So you tell my sister, Johnny, you know, I'm coming out of a test because I'm sure, that my peers come on and see it. So I told her, guess what? They're not going to be using these three tests as any marker. Coming up from one round. Even if they are right, so if they appear to come, so all the food is going to be leaving up to her. But for me personally, I'm using my peers 5 days. I'm going to use about things and stuff. So, what does this kind of mean? Also, to make my family work, when I have to take in December, right? When the period came, before the period came, I took 2 mornings after pills as a wife. So even the man when I didn't have, not from the man also, yeah. Even the man, the bigger man, yes, yeah, then stay in the sun. Miss Johnson, Daniela, ensure so what he thought he did, I erased it. So when I saw this result, I said, I joke this result of it. This must be one of it. And so we went ahead again to the pharmacy and we bought 2 more tests. We buy 2 more tests. And the results were the same. We do the deal, we go to the bathroom, we go for the same thing, we go for the same thing, and the results were the same. Both of the tests were reflecting that both of us were pregnant. Good. Let me also say something. When the second test result showed positive, I was still not convinced because guess what happened? In January, I told her I had seen my friend in December. I took her, taken a morning after pill, 2 mornings after pill in December as well. So the period came after taking the morning after pill, right? In January, when I was helping my sister to take the test, my there's another period for me in January. So I'm saying to myself, no. This test will never be right because I would have seen 2 periods, one in December and one early in January. So how could I be pregnant when my red red came in December and I did the thing and it came in January? So even though the difference between the red red in December and January is this, my red red in December was normal, regular, the same timeline, the same type of thing. But the red red that came in January, and it came maybe the first week of January. When it came for 2 days. And I said, people, me not normally feel pain when I see the pain. I've gotten so accustomed to the pain, which is the mild pain that I normally feel. And so when it's my time of the month, person's counseling, because I'm just the same person. But however, this railway that came in January was not like no other. Me say me couldn't even walk. The red one was so heavy, me couldn't walk. Me had to sit on my ball. Me had to sit on my ball. So in that chamber, me see character. When I took that test, I'm thinking to myself, these tests are not correct because I'm still not convinced. And so we said that we're going to go to a doctor. Yes. So when, because my sister was, well, you know, say, I didn't say any fear, like I was left with only one chance to say that I'm feeling. I was pregnant. Honestly speaking, when I listened to the test, my sister said, Lord, oh God, I want this. Just because of disobedience, me just follow myself. And I have no sex after watch night, then no, I bring it. But fast forward to we going to the doctor, because we had to go to the doctor just to confirm. As I said, even though I didn't get a firm, I believe the testimony because I didn't see, there was evidence because I didn't see any fear. But I still wanted to go to a doctor to confirm it for my sister, because at this time, you know, we're glad because I said, I'm going to go through this by myself. So this was a miracle. We got a doctor. I think there was a doctor in Fillmore. We went there and we did. Then when the person knew that was an ultrasound, they allowed me to take a pregnancy test. Yes, it was further confirmed that we were pregnant. But we did something. And then they put something on your belly and then he would tell you whether or not there's a fetus going in your stomach. And so my sister did her. Hers was 80, yes, it was 80. She was a girl, well married. So they were me perfect in mind, come here and say, I'm sitting this minute, come here and say, what is happening here? I do all the things that I needed to do. So how is it that I am pregnant? So even though I...
But when he did yours, when
he did mine, however, because when they put that gel tube over your belly and rubbed that machine over your belly, mine was a little bit inconclusive because the doctor was saying that it was a little bit too early. There seems to be something there, but it cannot be confirmed enough. And so I'm going to be visiting in 2 weeks or 4 weeks. Timeline, and he can further confirm, but at this present moment, there seems to be, people, so we come out of the doctor office there, and when I think about this message to myself, how are we going? So, is this, I'm going to fly for God,
remember now, it was,
remember, mine was already confirmed, because mine was 8 weeks. My sister was not, hers was not confirmed because according to the doctor, what he was just saying, that it was too early. You know, when he went back 2 weeks after,
yes,
it was confirmed. So both of us were pregnant. And then, remember, this test would have been able to tell you the timeline when you're going to be due.
Yes.
And mine was saying September 23rd, 27th. And yours was saying October 3rd.
Yes, October 3rd.
Which would have been a week after, which would have indicated that both of us would have been pregnant around the same time.
Exactly.
Without us trying it. And even though I went ahead and I did all that I needed to do to prevent this pregnancy, God said, you're not ready, but me ready. Because your sister is not able to go through this on her own. And so even if, by chance, I never ready, me have to fear you.
Exactly.
So when all of that happened, when I found out that my sister was pregnant also, for me it was like, yes, at least I have somebody outside of the father of the child to go through this with me. You know, you really want, when you're pregnant, you know, you really want somebody who knew where you have to choose. Because, you know, pregnancy comes to a lot of ups and downs. So you really want somebody who's close to go through with you. So I'm so thankful that my sister and I got the chance to share this journey together. And people, there's a life lesson coming from this. The life lesson that I have learned is, one, everything in life happens for a reason. What is your life lesson?
My life lesson is that God will not give you anything that you can't bear. So you will put persons in place. So now what I feel like, okay then, Lord Jesus, I want this. Anything that happens in your life is for a reason. God will put persons, people in your life.
In creation as well?
Yes, to help you along the way.
And what is for you will be for you.
Because I never think that this was for me, but God realized that my sister was not able to go through this on her own. And I have to be the shoulder that she would have leaned on. Even though I was ready, we have rather two beautiful babies, a girl and a boy. And guess what? The miracle still continues. The girl, my sister's baby, was born on the 23rd of September. And guess what day my baby was born on? The 26th, which means the day is apart. So when God is working, God is working. So we have come to the end of our video. I hope you enjoyed our story. We look forward to seeing you in our next video today. We do remember now to share, subscribe, like, comment, and hit that post notification bell so when another video drops, you can be notified. Bye for now. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.